interact with the students, and we do quite often with the students across the city, I take them down the journey of how the universe began about 1,30,000 years ago, and how the earth began 30,000 years ago. And civilization is just 5,000 years, and science about 200 years. And yet within these 2,000 years of human existence, we have been in a position to create for ourselves religions, races, creeds, castes. So in 2,000 years, man has been able to divide himself so many times, and so much of prejudices we have against each other. Though of course, the civilization, man probably existed about 1,00,000 years, but within this 2,000 years of our existence, we have been able to make this distinction. While science has progressed very fast, we have seen that along with it, social sciences have not progressed equally. And we see that 100 top billionaires of the world have about 25% of the world wealth. You know, if they give 1/4 of their wealth, the poverty of the world can be eliminated. We see that 50% of our population does not have households. Our 60% doesn't have electricity. We see a huge amount of inequality, and it's not because we are born unequal. We are born equal, but still society and societal forces have made us unequal. Not all of us receive equal education. We have the right of equal opportunity, but not right to be equal. So that's what our Honorable Deputy Chief Minister, I'm sure, is striving, that every child has an equal opportunity to study and achieve his position on the social ladder. Of course, in social sciences, some of you may call messiahs. We have had people who have changed the world. You heard of Karl Marx, who has changed, you know, the history of the world. Some of you will call messiahs, but I would consider whether it's Lord Buddha or Prophet Muhammad or Jesus as social scientists who have changed the way world looks at human beings. We have scientists, but we don't have those kind of people in today's world. And I look forward for a vision to this institute that we must develop people who are able to remove the differences, annihilate caste, remove the difference between religion, and make society a better place to live. These are things. The world is, of course, today you see terrorism, you see divisions, and these things cannot be solved by science, but can be solved only by social scientists. And we see greater and greater emphasis today, not only on environmental impact assessments, on social impact assessments. We have been associated with Rhoda Mystery in trying to take the message of social togetherness, social awareness, not just on hygiene, but on social differences to the people on the ground. I would like to end by saying that, you know, the father of our constitution, Dr. Ambedkar, said that our society is built on three pillars. The pillars of liberty, equality, and fraternity. Liberty, of course, we all have, or we try to have freedom to do what we want. Equality is still a goal that, you know, administrators strive for. We have equal opportunity, but there's no equality because you see so much of difference. A poor person's child cannot be equal to a rich person's child, and we are trying for that, for equality in education. But more important than liberty and equality, I would like to tell all the students here, is the concept of fraternity. Like, you know, family, children can fight against each other. They beat each other, they pull each other's hair. But at the end of it, the family thinks that they are together. If we want to have a nation, we have to have the feeling of fraternity, a feeling of siblings. And that, Dr. Ambedkar said, is the foundation of a nation. Irrespective of differences in religion, caste, or etc., you have to believe that you are a nation. And that nationhood will come when we don't have differences, and that can only come when the vision of such institutions is there to bring about a reduction in differences between people. Today there is so much of differences, so much of hate, that has to go, and only when fraternity is established through vision by institutions such as this can there be a future for our nation. Our nation says that we have a Hindu rate of growth. That's because we have a difference between us. But when we have equality, when we have fraternity, then our real growth potential will be unleashed. So I thank again Rhoda Mystery Institute for giving me this opportunity to present this vision. I believe that more than technology institutes, the need of the hour of the society is to bring about social justice and fraternity, and that can only be through social scientists who have that kind of a vision. And I hope this institute gives the vision of social fraternity to all its students, who will go and make this nation a great nation in future. Thank you.